Hello, and welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to discuss how to make a meteor camera to capture meteors as they stream through the sky. One thing people forget is the Earth is actually travelling at approximately 1,000 miles per hour. It's because of this movement that a lot of the meteors hit our atmosphere and burn up in it. So, the purpose of this video is to show you how to build your own meteor camera. The main parts are the Raspberry Pi Zero, the battery, and the camera, as well as some special software called Meteotux that automatically captures the images for you and overlays them and stacks them on top of each other to build up a brighter picture, even with a Raspberry Pi camera, which, though to be fair these days, are actually quite good. So, let's get started on how to build your meteor camera, and soon you'll also be able to capture images like this one shown here.
Okay then, well, to build a Meteor camera, you need a few things. You need an SD card with Raspbian loaded on it. You need a power pack to power the whole thing. You need a Raspberry Pi Zero W to record the data. You need at least a Raspberry Pi camera version 2. This is a no IR camera, so it'll be better in night. And this is the Raspberry Pi Zero case with camera hole and camera adapter in it. So before constructing it, it's best to actually remove any static from your body by doing something like touching a leg of a radiator. This will stop you destroying the delicate components on the board. Okay, so you use this more powerful camera with the Raspberry Pi Zero. We need to remove this connector here and replace it with this one that came with the pack here, the Raspberry Pi official case pack. So to do that, you need to pull back this bar and then pull out the cable and then replace it with a smaller one. Push in the bar. Okay, so now this way around you need to connect it to the main board. So again you need to slide out the back bar there. And then slot it in. Now I'm going to put in the SD card with Raspbian preloaded on it, following the instructions found on the link here. Okay, finally we need to slot the Raspberry Pi Zero into the case. And then let's put on the lid. Remember to try and line up the holes with the pegs on the inside there. And there we are, a Meteor camera. Okay, so I set up the Raspberry Pi, and I've also turned it into a hotspot. So now I'm going to connect to it and actually set up the rest of the Meteor camera software. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do is to actually enable the camera. So to do that, I need to go to Raspberry Pi configuration. Go to interfaces and then enable the camera interface. And then reboot to the Pi. Okay, I'm now going to check that the camera works. So to do this, I'm going to make a images directory, and then I'm going to test that we use the Raspberry still command. Navigate to the images directory and then type in the Raspberry still command. And it's done. So now let's go to that directory. That's quite pinky, but I imagine this is due to the fact that it's an OIR camera, so it's not really meant for taking pictures during the day. Okay, before going any further, I want to stop the LED on the camera from flashing. This could cause interference with the images we produce. So, to do that, just need to set the disable command in the boot config file. So, yeah, switch to super user, and then enter the echo command to write the value to the file. And that's it. Okay, so I've downloaded the Meteotux PI script and now I need to set it to executable. And to do this, so on the keyboard. Navigate to the correct folder. Add in the executable command. Like so, and then it's done. One more thing I need to do is actually to make an images folder inside here. So, and this is where we're going to store all of the stacked images of the night sky to. Okay, and then see the contents of the folder. Okay, so let's give this a little test. I've darkened this room as much as possible, but it could still end up being whited out. So I've I'm calling the actual Meteotux for the duration of 10 seconds. That means every 10 seconds it will stack all of the images collected within that time. The exposure is going to be 200 milliseconds per image, and the gain is 1. I've set these to the lowest allowed values to hopefully to avoid any issues with the stacking in brighter conditions than normal. So let's go and give it a go. Seems to be doing something. Looks like it's taking lots of images. And it saved an image, so let's stop it there. Okay, let's look what's been captured. There's two images there. And as you can see, there's a there's the ceiling there, my ceiling and my wall. Don't worry about it being pink, it's because it's a no IR filter, so it doesn't work so well in the day, but this won't be a problem at night.
Well, as it turned out, the pinkness was actually something else. I had to use a special setting called AWB is Auto Grey World. Now this allowed, this is recommended for no IR cameras, and once this was applied, the camera would start to behave properly. Well, I hope you found that useful. I'm actually building up a bank of Meteor photos so that I can do an in-depth review of the Meteotux software later. But from what I've seen so far, it just seems to be really good software. And they're releasing updates regularly, which is quite good. So if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, like that review, then please do subscribe. Like if you like this video, and comment if you've got any questions. But for now, goodbye and clear skies.